Hi, my name is Jacob Malbouef. I'm one of our mechanics here in the roundhouse at Greenfield Village. We are currently in the cab of Detroit and Lima Northern locomotive number 7. It's a 1897 Baldwin built locomotive, and we're going to show you a little bit about what it takes to operate it. So let's take it away. So number 7 is a steam locomotive, which means we burn about half a ton of coal a day here at Greenfield Village to boil several thousand gallons of water every day. We use the steam that's created as a result to make the locomotive move forward. So there's two crew members up here in the cab. There's myself, I'm the fireman today, so I'm in charge of making sure we maintain our boiler pressure, keep the water level in the boiler at a safe level, and just make sure the engineer doesn't have to worry about running out of steam for pulling the train. The engineer, Matt, today is over on that side of the cab. He's in charge of operating the locomotive and the train cars behind it, so he has control of the throttle and the brakes and which direction we go in. Up in the cab, there's all kinds of knobs and levers that do all kinds of different things for the operation of the locomotive. Right here is one of our two injectors. These are used to put water in the boiler. We store water in a car behind the locomotive called the tender that contains our spare water supply as well as our coal. Right here is our sight glass, which is how we tell how much water is in the boiler at any given time. Of course, we ring the bell and blow the whistles at all our railroad crossings. So then looking over to this side of the cab, we have our throttle, which is basically the gas pedal in your car. We have the Johnson bar, that's kind of like a gear shift lever, even though steam locomotives don't actually have gears, but that's what makes it go forward or reverse. He's got two different brake controls. One of them is the automatic brake valve, which controls the brakes on the cars behind the locomotive, and then the independent brake valve, which controls the brakes on just the locomotive. The engineer's job is to maintain the locomotive throughout the day when the mechanics aren't around, so he has periodic lubrication duties he has to conduct. Of course, as a part of my job, I have to shovel coal. So to add coal, I'm keeping an eye on our pressure gauge, and occasionally it'll drop a little bit, but my job is to try to make sure it doesn't drop more than a couple pounds. Our boiler pressure is measured in PSI, or pounds per square inch. So if it starts to dip a little bit, it's probably time to add some coal. The main indicator, though, is actually watching the smoke from the smokestack. So if there's a little haze coming out of the smokestack, that means I've got a pretty good fire going, as long as my pressure is maintained at a constant level. If the smoke starts to get clear, that probably means that it's time to add a little bit more coal, because smoke indicates combustion. But our main goal here is to operate the train in a safe way. The other goal, obviously, since we're hauling tourists and people, is that we want to give them the smoothest ride possible, so that's why the engineer is so important, is by controlling the train, he can control whether it's going to be a smooth ride or a bumpy ride.